two. Bet 'em right. Shout hallelujah on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you, Ben. And welcome to Card Sharks. Good to have you here. Thank you. And our thanks, too, to Rose Carniol of New York City for that opening poem. Thank you, Rose. And now, let's open the board and get to the cards. Janice and Bettina, if you will, start loading in two brand new decks of cards. We're about to start a new match with these card sharks. Ron Hanson, our champion. Hi, Ron. Good to see you again.
Great to be back.
Won't you tell us about yourself once again?
Hey, I'm a native Californian. I just recently got a promotion in a data processing company. I'm quite excited about that. And we're just in the process of moving to a new house, and I'm quite excited about that. And last show's really made me excited.
I can't say as I blame you, because you won $6,200 in cash. That'll make anybody excited, Ron. Good to have you back. Challenger we're meeting for the first time, Alice Reher. Hello, Alice. Nice to see you.
Hi.
Won't you tell us about yourself?
Sure. My name is Alice Reher. I'm from San Diego. I just recently retired after 25 years, and I'm certainly enjoying it, and I'm looking forward to giving some stiff competition.
That's the way to feel. You both cut the cards in front of
yes,
the audience.
Yes, we have.
Then we're all set to go. Good luck to both of you.
Thank
we'll
you.
Start a best 2 out of 3 match with a question to Ron. Ron, we asked 100 bachelors. Would you go out with a gorgeous girl who had a black belt in karate and said to you, "My hands are deadly weapons"? How many bachelors said they'd go out with her anyway?
Well, that deadly weapons could be kind of exciting, too, though. So, I think...
Maybe the final excitement, right?
Okay, I think a lot of bachelors like to live dangerously, so I'm going to say that's going to be 63.
Ron says that 63 out of 100 bachelors would go out with a black belt karate girl.
Well, the girl sure may like him, because, like, if he is a good karate player, he may be able to hold
her... No, she is.
She is. Oh.
Oh,
well, still, if he decided to hold a real tight, she may give him some of her chops. So I think it might be higher.
Higher? Yeah. You think they'd want to go out with her?
Yes.
All right, if it is higher, you'll play your cards first, Alice. If not, Ron plays his. The actual number of bachelors who would go out with a girl who had a black belt in karate is 81. Alice, you're right. It is higher. And the challenger starts off with a jack.
I'm going to keep that jack. I really am, and I'm going to go higher.
You're going to go against the odds?
I'm going to go against the odds,
she has
yes.
a feeling.
Come
is she
on,
right?
Queen,
higher than
go.
A jack?
Oh!
No. That was asking for a lot from intuition, Alice. Works out for Ron, gets a free chance at an
oh,
eye.
Go ahead.
Okay. I think I'm going to go with the odds, and I'm going to say that card's going to be lower.
And, of course, Ron knows he did not win the question. He could not change the card. Lower than a 9, it is
okay.
a 2.
Okay. Gonna keep on going. The next card will be higher.
Higher than a 2. Yes, a 4.
Okay, I'm gonna keep on going with the next card higher.
Higher than a 4. An 8.
I'm gonna freeze.
And we move over the freeze bar, and that protects Ron. He needs one card for the first game of the match. Alice, you gave him an opportunity
yes,
there.
Did.
Be careful. Alice, your first question. We surveyed 100 prison inmates. Now, these are all men who are currently serving time in a California state prison. And we asked these prison inmates, do you believe in capital punishment for convicted murderers? How many inmates said they do believe in capital punishment for convicted murderers?
That's a hard question.
That's why I asked,
believe,
Alice.
I know you did. What was the question again, please?
How many inmates in prison said that they should have capital punishment for convicted murderers?
I think they will go along with that. I really do. So I'm just going to say around 50.
Around 50, 50. Right up the middle. 50 out of 100. Believe in capital punishment.
Well, I think these inmates have a little bit at stake on this, so I think they're going to think it's going to be lower. I'll say a lower number.
Lower. The actual number of inmates who believe in capital punishment for convicted murderers is 34. You're right, Ron. It is lower. And we left off with an 8.
Want to change that 8, please?
Winning the question, Ron can change it to a 5.
Okay. We'll go higher.
If this is higher, Ron is the first game of the match for the win.
Yes!
Ron wins game 1. And $100. So, Janice, if you will, we'll set up for game 2. Same 2 decks of cards. Janice will deal out the next cards off the top of the deck. And, Alice, you need this game.
Yes, I do.
Question goes to you, Ron. Ron, we asked 100 teachers of high school sex education classes. If you had a teenage daughter, would you advise her to remain a virgin until she got married?
Ooh.
How many sex educators said they would advise their daughter to remain a virgin?
I don't know. I'd say these sex educators are advising them on a few other things, so I'm going to have to say that's going to be a fairly low number. They're going to be worried about other things, so I'm going to say 15.
15 sex educators would advise their daughters to remain a virgin, Alice.
Oh, no. I think it has to be higher. It has to be higher.
So you say higher.
It has to be,
the actual number of sex educators who would advise their daughter to remain a virgin until she got married is 54, very much higher, Alice.
Okay, good.
And the challenger starts game two with an eight.
I'm going to change that eight.
Changing the eight to a two.
Oh, boy. Higher
than a two. An
eight. Oh, good. Lower
than an ace. A seven.
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze. And now we move over the freeze bar, and Alice needs two cards to tie things up. And, oh, this should be fascinating. You remember the last question?
Yes.
All right, Alice. We asked 100 teachers of high school sex education classes, if you had a teenage son, would you advise him to remain a virgin until he got married? How many sex educators said they would advise their son to remain a virgin?
No. I think it would... Boys are different than girls.
That's true, Alice.
They are. No. I think it's... I know if it was me and it was my son, if he wanted to, go ahead. So I'm going to say it'll be about 50.
About 50. Right up the middle again. Ron, what do you think?
I don't know. If they're going to tell the girls not to and the guys too, they're going to run out of finding people to do it with pretty quick. I'm going to have to say it's going to be a little bit higher.
You say higher. Well, as I recall, it was 54 with the daughters. Let's find out. The actual number of sex educators who would advise their son to remain a virgin until he got married is 38. It is not higher, Alice. And Alice, we left off with a seven.
I'm going to change that seven.
Changing the seven to a queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen. Oh, no, not a queen. Ron, a big break for you. The champion has a king.
Okay, we'll go lower.
Lower than a king. A queen.
We'll go lower again.
Lower than a queen. A five.
We're going to go higher.
Taking the risk higher than a five. An ace.
Oh,
got to play it. I'll go lower.
For the championship, lower than the ace. Yes.
Oh.
Well, Alice, we thank you for joining us. And we have a nice party gift for you. Thank you. Alice Reher. Come on out here, Ron. Well, Ron, over $6,000 the last time. Maybe you'll do better this time. We'll get to the money cards right after this commercial break. Here we go.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Sharpshooter Sean. We've never seen it like that before.
You got a minute to win. Good luck.
If you suffer from heartburn two or more days a week, why use temporary treatments when you can prevent the acid that's causing it with Prevacid 24-Hour? With one pill, Prevacid 24-Hour works at the source to prevent the acid that causes frequent heartburn all day and all night. And with new Prevacid 24-Hour perks, you can earn rewards from dinner deals to music downloads for purchasing Prevacid 24-Hour. Prevent acid all day and all night for 24 hours with Prevacid 24-Hour.
Some things are easier with a do-over, like refinancing your mortgage. If you refied in the last 18 months, get an even lower rate with no closing costs, like today's 2.875% rate and APR. The do-over refi, only from Cash Call. Call 877-890-CASH.
We now offer phone service as low as $1.70 a month with Magic Jack Plus. That's $19.95 a year. No computer needed. Nothing changes. And now keep your old phone number. That's right. Keep your old phone number. Get Magic Jack Plus at Radio Shack.
So, what do you do when your little girl likes a big-name cat food, but you don't like what's in it? Things like chicken byproduct meal, corn gluten meal. I wanted something better that tasted great, too. That's when I took the True Blue test and found that Blue Buffalo is made with the finest ingredients. And I learned real meat is first. She loves Blue. I love what's in Blue. Finally, we're both happy.
Take the True Blue test at catcantest.com to find out what's in your cat's food. Chances are, you'll switch to Blue.
There's a place where the sky is always blue, and the kids always eat their vegetables, because the salad there is always served with the original Hidden Valley Ranch. It's the way ranch is supposed to taste.
Ron Hanson, our champion, with another $200. Are you ready?
I I am ready.
Let's get to the money cards. Come on, Ron. And you cut them in front of the audience, I trust?
Yes, I did.
And here we go as we give you $200 of new money. Janice will start dealing out the cards with three cards on the bottom. Bet them as you will. Move up to the second level. We'll give you another $200 of betting money and three more cards. Minimum bets, as always, $50 till you get to the top card. The big bet, there you must risk at least half the money. Good luck, Ron.
Okay.
Here's $200. You can, of course, change your base card on each of the three levels if you need to. And, Ron, you start with $200 and... a six.
Not too happy about six. I'll change that card.
All right, next card off the top of the deck. You must play this one. Oh, a ten.
Okay, I'll bet $100 it'll be lower than the ten.
$100 that this card is lower than a ten. No. Down to 100.
Okay, but it's a good card, though. I'll bet the whole $100 it's going to be lower than the king.
$100 lower than a king. Yes, a three. Okay. Way to go.
I will bet the whole 200, it'll be higher than a three.
All of it, $200 higher than a three. It is an eight. Doubling it to 400, and we give you another 200 as we move up, 600.
Don't want that eight. I'll change that eight, please.
You move up, and you can change it. With $600, you now have a queen.
I will bet $400, it'll be lower than a queen.
$400 lower than a queen. Yes, hey. With a five. Up to an even 1,000.
I'll bet... $500, it's higher than the five.
Big bet, half the money, $500, that this card is higher than a five. Yes! $1,500.
I'll bet $500, it is lower than a 10.
Big bet on the 10 this time. $500 lower? Yes!
Okay.
$2,000, and up goes the nine.
And that nine won't stay there very long. I'd like to change that.
Getting rid of it, changing the nine to a jack. Now, Ron, you must bet at least 1,000. You have 2,000 and a jack. What's your big bet?
I'll bet $1,000. It's lower than a jack.
$1,000. Lower than a jack. Oh, no. But you held off, and that gives you $1,000. And with 200 in the game, $1,200 for this one game of card shy. That was a good time to hold back, Ron. Way to go. That jack was kind of a tough card there. Nonetheless, you're now up to $7,400 in cash, Ron. And Ron will meet a new challenger in a moment. Right now, we're going to take time out for this.
When you take your laptop or iPad to a public Wi-Fi location, your personal information is exposed to hackers and data thieves, and your connection speed slows down every time another person logs on. With a NetZero 4G device, you can become your own personal hotspot and enjoy fast, secure internet access wherever you go.
NetZero 4G mobile broadband gives you private, protected internet access at super fast 4G speed. Call now or visit us online and try NetZero free for 1 year.
Other mobile broadband providers typically want you to commit to a long-term contract and pay $50 or more a month just to take the internet with you. NetZero 4G does not require a contract or commitment. And data plans start at just $9.95 a month.
Call now or visit us online and try NetZero free for 1 year. Get internet access anywhere, anytime with NetZero 4G mobile broadband. Call 1-888-223-1073 or go online to netzero.com/TV22.
It's Empire's Buy One, Get Two free sale. When you buy carpet with installation for one room, you can get carpet for two rooms free. You choose the carpet. You choose the colors, you choose the rooms, and we'll professionally install it when you want, even next day. Don't miss it, it's a fabulous offer. Buy one room of carpet, get two rooms free. Call Empire today.
800-588-2300-EMPIRE.
Today.
Introducing Debbie Boone for Lifestyle Lift.
Today, we're letting you know about Lifestyle Lift, a breakthrough medical process that really does turn back the hands of time. Imagine waking up, going to the mirror, and seeing yourself the way you looked years ago.
I'm a firm believer that if there's something you can do to make yourself feel better about yourself, then absolutely, go do it.
I looked
old, and now I look healthy, young. I never looked this good.
It's the first thing people look at. They look at your face. So I'm very, very happy that I had the Lifestyle Lift done.
Lifestyle Lift makes it possible to get noticeable, natural, and lasting results with options that take as little as an hour. And Lifestyle Lift is more affordable than you may think. Call the number you see on your screen right now to receive your free information kit. The call is confidential, the information is free, and there's absolutely no obligation. Give yourself the gift of a Lifestyle Lift.
And you know your heavy metal band's gonna suck when you've got a clarinet player.
Star of the Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson.
Get your motor running.
Craig Ferguson, live November 15th, on stage at the Chicago Theater. Craig Ferguson.
This is true. Somebody said that Craig Ferguson, yeah, he stole the whole Scottish thing from Mike Myers.
Tickets on sale now at the box office and through Ticketmaster. Don't miss A Hilarious Night with Craig Ferguson.
Janice is dealing out two brand new decks of cards. That means it's time to meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. Molly Stapleton. Hello, Molly. Nice to have you here. I'm fine. How about you? Tell us about yourself.
I'm Molly Stapleton. I'm a recreation supervisor for a city here in Southern California. I'm an avid racquetball enthusiast. I love cross-country skiing. I have a brown belt in karate. And my husband and I are going to shoot the rapids of the Rogue River in Oregon this spring.
Well, you are indeed a very busy, sports-minded lady there. Good luck. That
I
sounds
love it.
Fascinating, going through the rapids.
Yes.
Good luck with it, and good luck with you here. You've cut
Thank
your
you.
Cards?
Yes, I have.
Then we'll get started, Molly. As we start with a question to Ron, best two games out of three. And Ron, we asked 100 married men, if you bought your wife flowers, would it be a sign that you were feeling romantic or guilty? How many men said if they bought flowers, they'd be feeling guilty?
I think not too many men buy flowers, so it is going to tend to be on the guilty side. So I'm going to have to say that's going to be 42.
42 out of 100 men buy flowers because they feel guilty rather than romantic, Molly.
I think that it's going to be lower because I feel that if they give flowers, maybe the wife will think they are guilty, and it'll cause a fight rather than making up.
So you think that more of them would give flowers when they're feeling romantic rather
than
guilty.
Right. So it's got to be lower.
The actual number of married men who said if they bought their wife flowers, it would be a sign they were feeling guilty is 10. Much lower. Molly.
Terrific.
And the challenger starts off with a three.
Oh, great card, and I'll go higher.
Higher than a three, a king.
Oh, terrific, and I'll go lower.
Lower than a king, an eight. And we move over the freeze bar. Molly takes that two-card advantage. Molly,
yes.
We asked 100 first-grade kids, very simply, have you ever eaten a bug? How many first graders have eaten a bug?
I have eaten a bug several times. It's going to be about 20 children. I think that... they feel that they shouldn't be telling that they ate things they weren't supposed to.
Oh, I see. But 20 out of 100 first graders have eaten a bug, Ron.
Yeah. Got a little girl that eats flowers, and there's sometimes bugs on her flowers, so I'm going to say that number's going to be higher.
Even higher.
Even higher.
The actual number of first grade kids who've eaten a bug is 4, not higher,
oh,
Molly.
Hi, terrific.
I ate a bug once, but I had a little trouble swallowing the fenders. You've got an 8 there, Molly.
I would like to change that card.
Changing the 8 too. I'm sorry about that, Janet. Changing it to
oh,
2.
Oh, terrific, and I'll go higher.
Higher than a 2, at 6.
Okay. I'm going to go higher. I'll go for it.
For the first game of the match, higher than a 6.
Yeah.
So, the first game of the challenger. And we will set up for game 2 with the same 2 decks of cards. And if the audio man has made the corrections for Molly screaming, we'll get into game 2.
I apologize.
No, no. Listen, we want you to have fun and be enthusiastic.
I hope he didn't have earphones on.
No. No, no. You mean the deaf fellow up there?
Yes.
No, no, no. Okay, Molly, you've got game 1. And Ron, you need this one. Ron, our man on the street, went to a small city in Japan where he asked 100 married men, before you proposed marriage to your wife, did you ask her parents' permission? How many Japanese men said they did ask her parents' permission?
I think that's a pretty traditional thing. I would think a lot of Japanese probably are still doing that custom, so I'm going to say that's going to be 63.
63 out of 100 asked permission.
I think Japan is very traditional. And even my husband asked my father's permission before he asked me. And I'm going to have to go higher, especially higher. In Japan, yes.
The actual number of Japanese married men who asked their wife's parents' permission to marry her is 89. Oh, very much higher, Molly. Very much higher. Molly starts with a 4.
I'll take the 4 and I'll go higher.
Higher than a 4, a 5.
I'll take it again and go higher.
Higher than a 5, an 8.
I'm going to freeze.
Now, Molly needs just 2 cards to become the new champion. Molly.
Yes.
We asked 100 child psychiatrists. If your 5-year-old son enjoyed playing with a Barbie doll, would you take it away from him? How many child psychiatrists said they would take the doll away?
I feel that child...
5-year-old son.
Child psychiatrists feel it is healthy for both sexes to play with dolls. And I don't think it has anything to do if it's a Barbie doll or a Ken doll or whatever. I'm going to say it's fairly low that they would take it away, about 15.
Molly says that 15 out of 100 child psychiatrists would take the doll away from a son.
I don't know. I'm going to have to agree with her reasoning even more so, and I'll say it's going to be lower.
Even lower than that? The actual number of child psychiatrists who would take the doll away from their son is 9. It is lower. Ron, very much lower. And Ron needs this game. He starts with a king.
We'll keep that king and go lower, Jim.
Lower than the king. A jack.
I'll keep the jack and go lower.
Lower than a jack. An 8.
I'll freeze.
Now we have a tie with each of you needing 2 cards. Ron. Ron, we pulled 100 single women over 65 years of age and dating. And we asked them, at this point in your life, if you had to choose between a boring husband or an exciting lover, which would you pick? How many senior citizen women said they would pick the exciting lover?
Gee.
That's another good question. I would think that number is going to be fairly up the middle. I'm going to say 42.
Ron says that 42 would pick the exciting lover rather than the boring husband.
I think they would be higher. They would want an exciting lover. Maybe they didn't have it in their first marriage.
So you say higher. The actual number of senior citizen women who would choose the exciting lover is 79. Very much higher.
Terrific.
Why not? They're entitled.
That's right.
Well,
it's
you've
about
got an 8.
Time. I'd like to change the 8.
Winning the question, she can change it to a 7.
Oh. I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 7.
All right. I'm gonna go lower.
If this is lower, we have a new champion. For the win,
yeah! Oh my God.
Molly Dolan! There you go, and Ron, you're leaving us with $7,400. Thank you. You're 5 champion.
Thank you.
Ron Hansen, Molly, come on down here. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Molly Sableton, our new champion. We'll be back with her right after this. There you go. Tear it up with the money calls now.
Okay. Attention Medicare beneficiaries. Open enrollment is here. The time to choose your Medicare coverage begins October 15th and ends December 7th. So now is the time to consider the benefits and stability of an AARP Medicare Complete Plan insured through United Healthcare. What makes it complete? It can combine Medicare Parts A and B with prescription drug coverage and more, all in one simple plan that may cost you nothing over what you already pay for Part B. With an annual physical, preventive screenings, and immunizations all for a $0 copay, you'll also have the flexibility to change doctors from a network of dedicated providers. And it could offer you more, like vision and hearing coverage, and prescription drug coverage accepted at pharmacies nationwide. Remember, open enrollment ends December 7th. Start getting the benefits of an AARP Medicare Complete Plan. Call now.
If you have Medicare and have a chronic breathing condition, you can take your medication using an inhaler. Or this, a portable nebulizer from Med4Home. Independent studies have shown a nebulizer may be more effective and easier to use than just an inhaler. Impressive. It's like getting hospital-quality treatment at home. So call Med4Home today to find out more. Med4Home is a specialty pharmacy that's here to help you however they can. They'll deal with your doctor, the paperwork, even ship for free. And their pharmacists and respiratory therapists are available 24/7. What's more, your nebulizer and medications may even be covered by your Part B benefits. For a better treatment at a much better price, call Med4Home now to learn how a portable nebulizer can help you start breathing better today. For more information, call 1-800-210-8216.
Let me tell you something about the Newlywed Game. Don't ever play it safe.
The Newlywed Game, a brand new season Thursdays, starting at 8, 7 Central, only on GSN.
We are running short of time, Molly, so we wanted to give you a crack at the money cards. So once again, the cards have been dealt out in front of our audience. Good luck to you. Here's
Thank you.
$200.
Okay.
Let's see if we can start you off with a very good base card and make a lot of money. With $200, Molly, you've got a 10.
I'd like to change that card.
All right, get rid of the 10 and change it to a 3.
Terrific. I am going to bet all of it on the 3. $200.
$200,
oh,
higher than that
higher.
3. Yes, with a queen.
Terrific. I will bet all of it higher.
Higher than a queen?
I mean, I'm sorry. All of it lower than the queen.
Don't be nervous. We're with you, Molly. $400 lower than the queen. She's right with a 4.
I'm going to bet all of it higher.
All of it again, a big bet. $800 that this card is higher than a 4. It is. $1,600 as we move up the jack. We'll give you the other $200.
You've got $1,800. And I love that jack. I'd like to keep it. I'm going to bet $1,000 lower.
Big bet on the jack. $1,000 lower. It is. $2,800. You're up the middle, Molly.
I'm going to bet $100 lower.
$100 lower than an 8. It is a 3 for $2,900.
To bet $2,700 higher.
$2,700 higher than a 3. Yes! $5,600 and we move up the 9.
Please change the 9.
Big change. Come on, let's have a good card. A 6. Now, you must bet at least $2,800, Molly. You can bet more. You have $5,600 and a 6. What's your big bet?
I'm going to bet $2,800 higher.
Half of it, $2,800 higher than a 6. No! But by holding back, you've got $2,800, $200 in the game. That's $3,000, Molly. Beautifully done. Come on down here. We'll be right back with this fine champion right after this. $3,000 and not too bad.